Welcome back to another Pierson Workholding Q&A, and in today's episode, I'm going to be talking about my biggest machinery and equipment purchasing regrets. So it's been a while since we've done a Q&A. If you're new to the channel, this channel is dedicated to workholding machinery, CNC machining, and educating about lean and business practices. This is our Q&A series. And I just take a lot of questions that I get on a regular basis and answer them here for your benefit. So today we're talking about machinery and equipment purchasing regrets that I've made. Now, we all have regrets in life. I'm not immune to that. So specifically, let's jump right into machinery. Now, number one, I would say I've really enjoyed all the machines I've purchased. They're all a little bit different. I've learned a bunch about them. But the one machine that sticks out that I regret purchasing was my 2013 Haas Super Mini Mill 2. Now, I was at a point in business where I needed another spindle. And I was used to my model year 2000, still own it, Haas Mini Mill. And it's like a child to me. I've had it for so long, but I'm getting to the point where it might need to move out of the house. But I was familiar with the Mini Mill series. So in 2013, I went to West Tech and I saw one, and it was the right form factor. It was an upgrade from my just standard Mini Mill, like a non-super speed Mini Mill, the very basic one. And I ended up buying it. And what I was debating about was whether I should get a VF1 or a Super Mini Mill 2. At the time, it probably still are about the same price. But for the size and the familiarity, I went with the Super Mini Mill 2. Big regret. For me, the super means it's basically a super speed, high pitch ball screw. For the size of the machine, it was just scary fast all the time. The Mini Mills have a welded steel frame, and the table moved so fast that it would just shake a lot. You know, it wasn't like a firm, like dampening machine that I'm used to with like one of the VFs. One of the things that just you never got over, you know, you can set the rapid slower, but you couldn't get over the fact that the umbrella style tool changer was just in and out so fast. There was no 50 or 25 or 5% rapids on that. When you change a tool, boom, it changes. And it was just something that I never got used to. As far as the accuracy, it had a higher pitch ball screw, and from what I remember, it was more susceptible to temperature variations. So when the ball screw grew by just a few tenths because of the pitch, you would really see it show up in accuracy. And yeah, I just didn't like it. We ended up keeping it for a total of five years. And we sold it when we moved. So I owned it from 2013 to 2018. And in the latter years, we just moved all the non-critical tolerance type stuff to it. I would say that the Mini Mill series is great. I just can't recommend the Mini Mill 2, especially the Super Mini Mill 2, when a VF1 is just so much of a better machine. Now, I've already done another Q&A called Haas versus Tormach, where a customer asked me, hey, I'm debating whether I get a Tormach or a Haas Mini Mill or a tool room mill. And I talk about the differences between the Tormach, the tool room, the Mini Mill, and the VF series. Just the Mini Mill series to the VF, it's again a night and day machine. I wish I would have bought a VF1 or VF2. Lesson learned: don't buy the machine for where you're at, buy the equipment for where you want to go. Now, my next equipment purchasing regret would have to be my Doosan two-axis lathe. Now, not because it's a Doosan, not any of that, I'm not talking brand, it's because it's a two-axis lathe. That's a 220LC. It does not have a subspindle. My next machinery purchase was a Doosan 220LSYC, which has live tooling, it has Y-axis, and it has a full sub-spindle. It's about double the price. But if you think about it, it's more than double the machine. Not only do you have two spindles so you can hand off and have finished parts coming out, but you can also do milling. So we moved a lot of our simple milling, like where you would do an op one on the lathe and then put it in op two in a vise in typically our mini mill, and those machines were next to each other. It just created a workflow that instead of producing finished parts, it was an operator picking up that half finished part, putting it, doing a second setup in a mill, and then finishing it there. Yeah, I would never buy a two-axis lathe again, no matter what brand. Dual spindle, Y-axis live tooling is the way to go. And then in another, the next Q&A, we'll talk about the Q&A between my ST30 Haas versus the Doosan lathe. It's a real apples to apples comparison now that we've owned both machines for quite a decent amount of time to have a good opinion about them. And you'll see that in that I talk about how adding a bar feeder, it's like printing money. It's like printing money lights out all the time. So yeah, I would not ever recommend anyone buy a two-axis lathe. Lesson learned, buy for value, not price. The smaller Doosan was cheaper than the bigger one, but in the end, I paid a big price for it. Now, my next regret would be the first Universal Robots UR10 that I purchased. At the time, 2012 is when I bought it, so it's going back 8-9 years. I was a one-man shop, and I think I was thinking about hiring my first part-time worker. And I thought that worker would be a robot, right? A robot just shows up, it doesn't take days off, it doesn't complain, and it does exactly what you tell it to. And that's the problem. You gotta tell it exactly what to do. If you haven't, go back and check out our robot series. We have to program it to do everything right, but we also have to make consider all the things that could go wrong if it doesn't pick up a part, if it goes to pick up a part and it's not there, if it misloads in the vise, all those things. The part of the story with the robot series, I owned that robot for maybe like 6 months, and I immediately sold it and hired my first rock star employee, John, who then was able to, my shop suddenly became voice operated. I can hand him a print, stack of material and say, make this, and it would just happen. So the robot, I regret buying that. I lost $4,000 or $5,000 on the resale, put it into another piece of equipment. I just wish I never did that, but hey, I learned a ton from making that buying mistake. Lesson learned, a robot is not a replacement for a human. Invest in people, then free them up through automation. Well, that's it for now. Gosh, I'm gonna keep thinking on this one because we all make mistakes in business. I love mistakes. They show us the areas where we need to improve so that we can document it, set a process in place so that we don't make those mistakes again. But if other regrets come to mind, I'm definitely gonna save that for another Q&A. So subscribe if you're interested in this type of content. So until next time, go innovate your production.